Welcome back to the channel. In today's video, I'll be covering how to create a Gantt chart in Excel. They are often used for project management and is a great way to visualize and track the progress from a start date to an end date for different tasks or projects, as well as document the process along the way. And they're relatively easy to create in Excel. There's a few things we'll need, mainly being the start and end date, and then some days to track that correspond to these dates. So the start date here is the first, and we have day by day going to the right of this row. You could also track by week or month. The current day will be useful later, which we'll talk about. And then you'll probably want a name of a task or project, and it might be nice to have the assigned lead of that task or project, as well as maybe tracking the amount of days left. We'll get into some other variables we can add to create a more dynamic Gantt chart, but for now, we'll keep it simple. I already have the first start and end date in here, but I know that if I fill in all of these start and end dates, it will go to row 22. And what we're going to want to do is create conditional formatting in these cells based on these dates right here. So we can just grab these cells right here and go into conditional formatting and create a role that will color them differently based on the start date and the end date and the dates that we are tracking up here. So we will use a formula to determine the format. And this formula, being if it's true, we will create a different format for the cells, will be equals and. So and will be checking multiple conditions. The first condition we want to check is if this start date, but we want to keep it in column D since that will be where our start dates are. So we can keep that dollar sign, meaning it's fixed in column D and fixed in cell 9 or row 9. We can get rid of that dollar sign, and then this will be is less than or equal to H8 since that's our first date, but we want it to stay in row 8 but move along these columns, so to I, then J, K, and so on. So then we can put a comma here starting our next condition. So now our next condition can check if this end date, getting rid of the dollar sign at the 9, is greater than or equal to this date in H8, and get rid of the dollar sign or the fixed value before the H. So we can close this parenthesis, then we'll want to click format, and in the fill section or the fill tab, we can now pick a color. So we could pick a light blue in this case, click OK, and click OK again. And so now this will be basing off the start date and end date. So we can go to this next one and select 01/05/2025. And then we will want an end date as well. So we can make this 01/15/2025. And once these two are filled out, we can see that it automatically filled in the days that correspond with our task. So we could be naming the task implement system and then just add a 2 on there. We could add the same assigned lead. And so now we can add a current date to change the color. So one way to add a current date would be equals now. This will automatically, every time you open the sheet, come in with today's date. But for this example, we'll just type a date. So we'll say it's the 7th of January, the year 2025. So now we can use this current date to slightly adjust the format we have going on. So we can go into conditional formatting, and one easy way to do it will be going to manage roles. This worksheet, we'll go to edit role, and we'll just copy this formula. We'll hit Control Z, just highlight, Control C, click OK. We'll just want to select the same range as before. Go to conditional formatting, click new role, use a formula to determine. We'll paste in that formula that we just copied. And then at the end of this 8, we'll just add another comma, which is adding one more condition to the and. We will put this value, which is H8, but we want to get rid of that dollar sign to not make this a fixed column. Is less than this value, which we can just leave as a fixed value since it's just a current date cell. We can make this a slightly darker blue, meaning that these days have already passed. You could also make it less than or equal to also include these days. So then this is one way to already show what days have passed and know what days are yet to come. We can also just add comments in these as a way to document need a task done. So that would be one way to just track a project, is just by adding notes in the cells. And it's very useful to do this in Excel because of the ease of documentation and just adding whatever you want to each column or cell. But we can even add another layer. So if we grab the same range and click new row, we can also add a formula. And then this time after the 8, we'll add another comma to create another condition. We can click on this cell, get rid of the fixed column in H, put a equal sign and equals this current date. We can set a format that set it to red to really stand out. We'll click OK. And so this will be a really quick way for today's date to stand out. And so let's say we change the current date. This will be a dynamic chart. It will just automatically update to where now it says the 8th is today's date and the 7th already happened. And this makes it an even easier visual indicator of the different dates involved with the task or project. So now adding in the days left, this will just be an extra field. We could type equals if. And so what this if will check, logical test that if the current date is less than the end date, the value will be the end date minus the current date. And then if that is false, we can add in double quotes, we can just do a dash, which is just saying that there's no days left. So let's say we change this to the 11th. We can see that now there's a dash just saying that the current date's already past the end date. So that could be another indicator of just how many days are left. We can change this back to the 8th. And as we just fill in the different days down, we can see that it just keeps changing based on that. And then all we need to change is the task, assign a lead, and we could just drag this formula down. And actually we'll want to go back into here, make this A5 cell fixed. So now we could just simply drag down this formula and it automatically tells us how many days are left. So this is already looking pretty good, but there is another thing we could add. So if we just add a row, then we can just format paint and then add whether it's critical. So this will be if it's a critical task. We can use the new checkboxes that were recently added into Excel to even make this more dynamic. So if we go to insert checkboxes, we can then grab the same range as before, go to conditional formatting, new row. So this will be the same exact formula we were using before. So we can actually just copy and paste that one since it will save us a little bit of time. Click new row. And it will be this exact formula, and it even moved it from H to I, but we can put a comma, and then we can put that this cell equals true. And then we can make this a totally different format. So let's just make it like a purple, saying that this critical checkbox is marked. So we'll click OK. And now we can actually go back in there and make sure that we edit this row to make the G9 go down in rows, but stay in this column. Then we'll click OK and OK again. And now we can see that made it so in each cell or in each row that this is checked. We completely changed the color. And we could actually manage this row for this worksheet. And this will be a hierarchy. So if we press the down arrow, that means today's red cell will still show up. As before, it was hidden. And we're well on our way to making a very dynamic project management chart. And you could add as many of these in here as you want and just make that and with the conditions even longer to check for a wide variety of different conditions. But that's all I have for you in this video. If you enjoyed the video, remember to like and subscribe. And thanks for watching.